Seth Green was only 8 when he started acting alongside Jodie Foster before landing the lead role in Woody Allen's Radio Days. Versatile and prolific, he's played fan favourite Oz in Buffy the Vampire Slayer, shown us his evil side in Austin Powers, and voices the dim-witted Chris in Family Guy. He's also the co-creator of Robot Chicken, the Emmy Award-winning animated comedy series that parodies pop culture, celebrity, and TV using the toys that we grew up with.
We have a magical clone of He-Man.
Da, 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 da.
What the hell is this, Beastman? He's blue.
Well, I'm half dog. Everything's shades of gray to me.
Me, He-Man.
And his personal pronouns are all f***ed up. I mean, where's the verb in that sentence?
It's not easy being Seth Green.
I'm good, man. How you doing?
I'm sure you are. I'm sure you're doing very well. Did you ever get hit as a kid?
Oh, yeah, I got hit all the time. I was a bad kid.
What did your parents use? What are they using in
usually
America?
Usually an open hand, sometimes a closed fist.
On special occasions.
Yeah, you know, I was a really bad kid.
Ever get your knees taken out with a shotgun?
Yeah.
Not that bad.
And then I had them replaced with robotic ones, but they had to be like several inches shorter.
Oh, yeah, one of those.
I wish I had that excuse as well. Now, are you pretty much living every boy's dream? I mean, we've all played with the toys and made them come to life. Yeah. You're doing it now for a living. It's
made
a pretty cool, pretty
made a
cool
show
gig.
Out of it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't even know how that happened. It just seems so improbable. But my buddy and I sort of reverse engineered a show. We started making shorts and then we made that into a we collected all those shorts and went around to a bunch of people trying to sell them a show, and we eventually sold it to the Cartoon Network's Adult Swim in the States, which has been syndicated all over. And then all of a sudden we're showing up in places and people are like, Robot Chicken, and I'm like, really?
it's a weird thing for people to yell. Where does the name come from?
It all started by accident, as everything with the show has. We were writing the first season before we even had offices in my living room and ordering from the same Chinese restaurant every day. And we noticed a menu item called Robot Chicken. And this is true. We're looking through the menu and we're like, do I want beef and broccoli or robot chicken? And we just thought that was so funny that we ordered it. And then it was really delicious. And then when we were trying to come up with titles for the show, everything we submitted got rejected or couldn't go through clearances. Someone else had already claimed a copyright, or a Google search yielded a porn site, or everything we submitted they hated so much that they called us the Bad Title Factory. And then we, as a joke, submitted Robot Chicken, thinking we have to at least give them 4. And they were like, Robot Chicken, that's what the show is. And we were like, really?
Well, look, appropriate, because it's tasty.
Yeah.
And because it's on cable, repeats on you quite a bit as well.
And luckily, not trademarked by that Chinese restaurant. Yeah.
And now they get sued. You could sue them for stealing the title. It's genius.
We have.
Good for you.
But they pay us in food.
Awesome. Hey, one of my favorite things you have done with Robot Chicken is you've created a couple of Star Wars specials.
Oh, yeah.
Now, I know for a fact that if you do anything Star Wars related, you need George Lucas's approval. Approval to say Luke and Leia have had sex?
We were just bold enough to ask. And they were like, go for it.
Really? Are there rules? Does he have any kind of list of things you can and can't do?
That was surprising. We were really surprised that they let us put Luke and Leia in bed together.
Is it a case of asking George Lucas, or is there like someone who takes all those calls? Who do you actually ask?
Well, we wound up communicating with the people at Lucus Film, and then eventually getting to hang out with George himself. And then he appears in our first special as himself. So we've gotten to know him a little bit, which is a really surreal experience. He's so funny. He's like your granddad that loves sci-fi.
What do you do if he asks you for your opinion on something Star Warsian? Can you be honest and say, the Jar Jar Binks thing?
Not really. I mean, I try to figure out what his opinion on it is first. And I'm like, what do you think about that? The kids, I don't know, they didn't tape, but great idea. He's great, and bizarrely self-effacing and really self-aware, you know?
And then lets you do whatever you want with his characters?
Well, I mean, in the first special, the team there advised us against using the word penis at one point. But it wasn't a funny joke anyway, so we abandoned it willingly.
It wasn't a funny joke? That's impossible.
You'd think, yeah, we'd already kind of done most of the joke. It was a thing with these space slugs trying to catch the Millennium Falcon, and they complain that they never get them. They're so hungry, let's order food from a takeout place. And, you know, they're waiting and how long it's going to take, and then they start playing charades, and one of them's like, oh, what are you then? And he's like, oh, I don't know, are you a penis? And he's like, no, no, keep going. He's like, you're not supposed to talk. And he's like, oh, right. it just wasn't... Like,
I would love to see a memo with a Lucasfilm letterhead that has all that you cannot say penis. We will have less penis in there.
Here's how savvy they are. It was a phone call.
Oh, Lucas!
No evidence for you to bring.
And also, one of the other things that most people would know you for is your voice of Chris Griffin in Family Guy. Mm-hmm. Do you get asked that a lot for people to, you know, leave the voice on
messages?
Most common thing
is a voicemail message.
Is it really?
When I was a kid, I was lucky enough to do a cartoon with the guy that played Snarf on the Thundercats.
Oh.
Right? So, and I asked him for my buddy's birthday. This was even before the answering machines. I asked him for my buddy's birthday to call, and he did Snarf's voice on my buddy's answering machine, and that delighted me so that when people are like, will you do this? I'm like, yeah, all right. You know what I mean?
Oh, cool. That's pretty cool.
It's not very funny. It's just a sentimental story.
And I hear... that's all right. So he will do it, but won't say penis, just so you know.
Yeah.
No, hey, speaking penis. Of, Seth, are you ready for your public probe?
Oh, my God.
Oh, here's one from Sarah in New South Wales. If you could play any role in Star Wars, who would you play?
Lando Calrissian.
Oh, okay.
Because he is about as cool as can be. He's the only black dude in the universe at the time. And even though he sells out his buddy, he winds up saving him by going undercover. Come on. Lando!
He's done his homework. From Siobhan in New South Wales, do you have an evil maniac laugh? And if so, what is it?
Do I?
Maybe you don't.
It's probably committed to film. I don't know. Check my IMDb.
Jenna from Victoria, I think this is a good question. Why does Fred Flintstone have regular cartoon eyes, but Barney Rubble just has weird black circles?
Yeah, that's... I don't know. It must be their... the region they were raised.
I'd love to see the character backstory for Barney Rubble.
Justin from Western Australia, have you ever eaten a crayon?
Well, I mean, not in the last 30 plus years, but yeah, I ate all kinds of stuff when I was a kid.
What was it taste like? I've never eaten crayon.
It's waxy and, you know, the
I have color. Crayons here if you'd like to recreate.
They would all you? Taste the same, unfortunately. There's really no...
Because it's the one thing I've never... I've probably
well, you
got to
break
eaten.
It from the core. You don't want anything that's been exposed.
Eating etiquette with Seth.
Do different colours taste? I'm gonna go.
No, it's really sad that they don't.
Red will be nice and strawberryish.
You don't think it won't be? They all taste like horrible wax.
Do you peel it first?
You have to peel it
like a banana.
It's worse than I remember.
The raspberry red's better.
He's right. That's not ripe yet. That is not ripe yet. Well, now I'm glad we've done that because other than that, do you know what I was thinking? I've been doing my research on you during the week. Born in 1974,
yeah.
You are an Aquarian.
True.
You love Star Wars, love wrestling.
All accurate.
You're a bit of a short ass. And
documented.
Now we've both eaten crayons. Yeah. I think we are the same person. That's just a theory I have. My eyelashes aren't as nice as yours. But other than that,
I've got groomers.
Do you know what I think? I think if we swapped roles, no one would even notice.
Really?
Do you want to do this last bit yourself?
I'm game. Let's do it. Oh, you want me to run the show? That's weird. What?
Just this bit. Why don't you sit there?
Here?
Yeah, and I'll sit here.
In the big boy chair?
Yes. Your feet will swing. And you can do, if you reach under the desk, you'll find your DVDs there and you can do your own plug.
Can I?
Yeah. No, no. See if you, and now, everybody, cut a shot to these guys.
Just distracting.
Who knows what's happened? Nothing's
blah,
happened.
Blah, 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 blah.
Hey, man, it's like, it's as it was anyway. So
and the super awesome Robot Chicken season 4 is out on DVD December 2nd.
Thanks,
but
man.
You can get the rest of the super awesome Robot Chicken DVDs now. These two available. Thank you so much, Seth Green.
Hey, man, no problem.